Another beautiful morning here at Aoraki Mount Cook National Park, and I'm climbing up Whitehorse Hill, which is at the very beginning of the Hooker Valley track. So Whitehorse Hill here is an old moraine. It's a pile of debris that has been brought here by the Mula Glacier. And believe it or not, it's only 150 years since the glacier was at this level. So all of that cliff has appeared in the last 150 years as the surface of the Mula Glacier has lowered and lowered more and more, and eventually melted to create the Mula Glacier Lake. So today we're going to walk up the Hooker Valley to the Hooker Lake, which is another example of these big glacial lakes. And we're going to take in some of the features that are left behind as the ice retreats, as the climate gets warmer and warmer. So here you see at the end of the Mula Lake, some sort of semicircular ridges of rock. And these are moraines. This is the rocks that have been brought here when the glacier was bigger than it is now. So as the ice retreated, the moraines start to form a concentric sequence, with the oldest moraine furthest out and the younger moraine closest to the glacier. When we look at these moraines, you can see that they're a chaotic jumble of large rocks and little particles all mixed up together. We've come up to the Hooker Lake, which is one of New Zealand's most spectacular walks. This valley here has been created by the Hooker Glacier. A great glacier like this would have hundreds of meters of ice, and all of that weight bearing down on the valley floor means that it is carving off and breaking off chunks of rock and dragging them along with it so that they act like a rasp and even accelerate the erosion that's going on. So because the valley has been carved so deeply by the glacier, tributary glaciers coming in from the sides have actually been left high and dry because they don't have the same ability to cut down through the landscape. So we call those hanging valleys. And along the side of the valley here, you can see several beautiful examples where they're sort of high up valleys. They've got the same U shape, but where the ice ends, there's a steep cliff below them coming down to the main valley glacier floor. You'll notice that the spurs that come down between the hanging valleys end with a kind of triangular face, and that's called a truncated spur. The triangle is made because the main valley glacier has basically carved off the end of the spur in its powerful erosion downward to make the bigger valley that they butt up against. The lake here in the Hooker Valley, like the other great glacier lakes, started to develop in the late 1970s. Water has a much more erosive power on ice than air and sunlight. So once a lake gets established, the water keeps eroding back into the glacier and the ice front keeps retreating faster and faster. You can see on the lake here we have icebergs. These have fallen off the ice front and been blown by the wind to the end of the lake, where they will slowly melt away. The icebergs, interestingly, have a notch underneath them because the water cuts into them, and as it does so, they get lighter and lift up out of the water a little bit and eventually tilt over, so that the icebergs end up with a very interesting sculpted shape.